You're the old Manchester lad, yeah? What's happened to your hair, man? Is that a new style on the street?
Takes him half an hour every morning, will you?
So do your hair like that? Can you feel it? Is it hard? Jeez. The pace of ball's got to be right, a little bit quick. And you've got to have the right people around you to make you do it. You can't. There's no point in doing it when there's no one there. It's good you've got to look around before you, innit, and see what's happening around you. Make sure there's no players in your way. If there's someone around you and you need to get out of trouble, maybe just not just doing that. There's not enough sometimes. You might have to put a little feinting to go backwards again. It depends how it comes as well. I think for me personally, if I say to myself, I'm going to do a certain skill when the ball comes to me now, it doesn't really work as well, does it? I think it's when it's just off the cuff, when it just happens like that, when the ball comes into you and you don't think about it and you just do it automatically, that's when it works the best.
Where would you use the skill in the game?
When someone passes the ball and like there's a few players around me and I'm under a little bit of pressure and I need to get out of the way, that's when you use it to get out of trouble and then pass it to a teammate. Because sometimes you don't want to just kick it into the stands when you're under pressure, you want to be able to keep the ball for your team.
Where else on the pitch would you use a skill?
And where do you play?
Left wing or up
left wing
front.
When you're up left wing or up front, yeah. When someone gives you the ball and you've got someone up behind you maybe, you're away from trouble.
Rio, shall we test them? Shall we play them a couple of balls and then see how they work?
Let's see how they can do it.
Lionel, can you step out? Step out on this side. Rio's got the ball. Rio's closing you down.
Yeah.
Can you get out?
Give him an easy one first.
That's
nice.
It. Well done, Lionel. Right.
How old are you?
10.
Right then. Put him under pressure, Rio, now.
Yep.
Come on, Lionel, you ready?
Oh, oh, nice.
All right. Can you do the same thing? Lionel.
Yeah.
Can you do the same thing, but do a Rio skill. You know what I mean? Just flick it behind. See, you want to see if that works.
See, I'm a skill. That's nice. Yeah.
That's it. Well done. Right, anybody else? Tom, because you're left-footed.
Yeah.
Right? So you might do it with your left to get out of trouble. Good lad. Good stuff.
Nice.
Good stuff. Brilliant.
See, when I was growing up, it was a lot more about on the winning the games and stuff like that.
Yeah.
When you used to see all the skills on the council estates, however, on the streets, and they used to see the skills, but not in the football clubs.
Yeah.
Nah, hopefully it seems to be coming back.
Practice your skills whenever you can, wherever you can. If the biggest club in the world values this, you should too.
From your own personal point of view, are there a couple of other skills that you know, like in the game, you
I
feel comfortable
do.
With?
Yeah,
like,
the one, it's like, I'll call it, it's like the, I know Peter Beardsley used to do it all the time.
Right.
To get a bit of space to shoot, but yeah, you know that one where you go like that.
Oh,
you're running
right,
at somebody.
Just a little.
Yeah, or the ball's coming towards you, say you play him in the ball. I think I'd have left you for dead there. Well, that normally gets you a yard normally. If they don't know you, sometimes if a player knows you and you do it all the time, then you can get into trouble. But that's where you need to have variation on skills.
Oh, absolutely right.
But how would the world's most expensive defender fare against some world-class players of the future?
We won the
good stuff.